Good evening, everybody, and welcome to our spring concert. Are you excited to be here? Well, we are certainly excited to have you. My name is Brad Mariska. I'm one of the band directors here, and on behalf of myself and my colleagues, Elliot Dalma and Aaron Holmes, we welcome you to our spring band concerts. We're going to be featuring the Varsity Band at this first concert. They're gonna play three tunes, and then they're gonna do a fourth tune in collaboration with our wind ensemble, which is gonna be really special, and that's why you see a bunch of extra chairs up here on stage. So when we get to our fourth piece, there will be some students added. And after that, there will be a pause, and at 7 o'clock, the concert band, symphonic band, and wind ensemble will give their performances along with a very special senior recognition and slideshow and the presentation of some awards. This is just such a great concert and a great evening. And whether you can only stay for 30 minutes or whether you can stay for the whole evening, we're really grateful that you are here and we're grateful for your support. We do ask that there are no food or beverage in the recital hall other than water, if you have it in a bottle with a cap that's sealed so that it doesn't spill all over. You are welcome to take photographs. Just make sure that the flash on your camera is turned off so it doesn't distract others and distract performers. And I would like to issue a special welcome to anybody who's watching us on the live stream. As you know, the past couple years, we've been very fortunate to have a great tech crew that makes sure that anybody who cannot attend in person can view our concerts, whether they are simply unable to get here or whether they are far, far away. So we welcome everybody who is watching this evening on the live stream, including my parents. So I'm gonna give a shout out to my parents who are watching from home tonight. So that's great. Anyway, we're going to get right down to it because you didn't come here to hear me talk. We're going to talk not a lot in between our songs this evening because we want to leave the focus on the students. And the first piece that we have for you is a really fun little march. It's called Court Jester March, and it's going to kick off our concert. Once again, thank you so much for being here. Thank you for supporting music education, and we hope you have a great evening. Thank you. Just a beautiful, beautiful tune. These students are amazing. They learned that song in about a week. We had just gotten back from our performance at the MMEA Midwinter Clinic back in February up in Minneapolis, and we were going to a ninth grade festival in Edina about a week later. And I told the students, I said, how cool would it be if we just like quick learned a new song so we don't have to play the exact same music? And they learned that piece in a week, and it's just gorgeous. And they bring to light and truth the title of that piece. These students, all of the students on the stage tonight, are the hope of tomorrow. And I'm sure they make all of you proud. They certainly make us proud. And they're very busy. We had students coming in from La Crosse. Some of these kids ran a track meet this afternoon. Caden is still in his baseball uniform, and that is like super cool because Bandits, yeah, give. Band is just one of many, many great activities and classes here at Farmington High School. And we want students to be well-rounded and do a wide range of events. And sometimes kids have to make really difficult choices. And back in January and February, when kids were registering for classes, it might be that a few of these students didn't sign up for band for next year. And if they've changed their mind, or you as a family have changed your mind, we put something new in the program this year. Right next to the main program, there's a big QR code. And if you want to get signed up for band for next year, you just have to fill out that form, and it'll send a response to the counselors here at FHS, and they'll make an appointment with the band student and see if we can find a way to get band to work with student schedules for next year. Because you've already heard, like, isn't this band, like, amazing? Aren't they great? Yeah. I want each and every one of them to keep playing. And after this next piece, you'll really be blown away. This is one of the greatest soundtracks ever written, Pirates of the Caribbean. All right, so as these students are finding their new seats for this really cool collaboration, I want to point out one thing that I think is especially awesome about this, is that Wind Ensemble performed this piece back at the Band Jubilee back in, April? And Ms. Holmes had the idea, she was like, hey, we should play, have the varsity band play this piece and do a collaboration with the Wind Ensemble. And it's so cool. It's a very powerful piece of music. It's loud, and there's a lot of students on stage. But I just think that this is such a great opportunity to collaborate. These two bands don't get to work together real often. And I think the other thing that is super important here is that this is going to be conducted by a student conductor. Hannah Baum has been one of our TAs during first hour of varsity band this trimester. And not only will she be conducting tonight, how we doing? They're doing great. They're just trying to find their seats real quick. Some students couldn't be at rehearsal because, like we were talking about earlier, they're busy and they left early to go to games and meets and all of that sort of stuff. So I'm going to trust that behind me they're all figuring it out. It's not that complicated. It's like, but what's really cool about this that you don't see at a concert is that Hannah actually taught most of this to the varsity band. The vast majority of this was rehearsed in class under her direction and under her baton. And Hannah's going to be studying music education at North Dakota State University in the fall and going to become a band director. So we're really proud of her and all of these students. Let's give Hannah a round of applause. All right, looks like we're just about there. So I'm going to put the microphone down. We're going to get the last few kids into their seats. And this piece is called Iron and Ice, A Viking Adventure.
Thank you. appreciate it. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Farmington High School Spring Band Concert Part 2. We just had an excellent performance by Varsity Band with a collaboration with Wind Ensemble for One Piece. I can tell there's a few folks over on this side that are still looking for a place to sit, and I've got a few open seats over on this side. If there's a way to come around, we might be able to get a couple more seats. But I know it's going to be crowded, and we might hit standing room only here. My name is Elliot Dalma, and behind me is the concert band. I've had the awesome privilege of working with this group all year. We've had some really awesome growth. I'm stalling a bit just to help a couple people have time to sit down here, but we're going to try to keep the talking down to a minimum tonight, because I don't know if you've looked at the program, but there's 3 bands, a bunch of awards, senior recognition. There's a lot going on tonight, and we want to keep things moving. So, let's go ahead and get things kicked off with Concert Band.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Brad Mariska, and along with Elliot Dauma and Aaron Holmes, we are so grateful that you are here. There's a lot of information in the program. Don't be afraid to leaf through it during these pieces to learn more about what happened this year and all of the great activities that these students are in. I think it's super cool. We had students coming in at the last minute tonight. Some of them have been to a track meet already this afternoon. Some of them have played baseball and lacrosse games. And we just think it's super awesome at all the different activities that these students are involved in. And life is so busy, sometimes it's hard to fit it all in. And we were kind of inspired by our middle school colleagues a couple of years ago. They said, hey, what if we put a special QR code in the program so that families or students who want to get registered for band for next year, who maybe didn't think there was enough room in their schedule back in January to get one second chance at it. So we've got that QR code in there. So if there's any students or families that want to get re-registered for band for next year. You hear how awesome this group is. I had the privilege of working with the brass students a lot throughout the course of the year, and I'm so proud of all of you. But it's really cool. So feel free to look through the program. There are a few things that are not listed. For example, as soon as concert band is done, as soon as we get symphonic band seated, there's going to be a special award that's not listed in the program. So anyway, I'm going to stop talking and turn things back over to the concert band. All right. Hey, can we give another round of applause to the awesome concert band? That was really nice job, really fantastic. I would like to introduce you all to a very important fourth generation owner, operator of Schmidt Music. His name is Doug Schmidt. And before the symphonic band plays here, he's gonna say a few words and present a very special award to our director of bands, Aaron Holmes. So let's give it up for Doug Schmidt and Aaron Holmes.
You guys have a smoking band program here. That was the first two concerts were great, and I expect the next two to be as great. As Brad said, I'm Doug Schmidt. I'm one of the fourth generation owners of Schmidt Music, and I bring you greetings from my brother Tom, who is our other fourth generation owner. And now we are fortunate enough to have two of our sons involved in the business, Ted and Pete, and so we're in our fifth generation, 125 years. Woohoo! Yeah, there aren't many family businesses that get that privilege, so I feel very fortunate, and it's so fun to be able to work in music. It's just great. So I'm here today to do one of my favorite things, celebrating the best music teachers in the 6 states and 400 school districts that we serve. We started this award back in 2015. A panel of past winners selects our new winners. The first year we did it, we had college directors that got us started, and then we had a set of directors that could help us keep picking winners. So they pick one winner in elementary, one in middle school, and one in high school every year. We then give each winner a Schmidt Music gift card worth $2,000! Just like that. We also got to have a fun dinner, so we have to plan that out. So we got to talk. And the prerequisites for this award are you must be teaching this school year. You must teach either elementary, middle school, or high school. And you must have a minimum of 3 years' experience. And you also must contribute to music education outside of the school district. Schmidt Music appreciates all of our music educator friends. We recognize that each one makes a monumental contribution to music education and to the lives of their students. We want to celebrate educators who go above and beyond, who contribute in and out of the classroom, and who are revered by students and community, and who deserve an ovation for their efforts. Know of anybody like that? Drum roll, people. Get ready to drum roll. Okay, so just get ready on the cue already. Okay, so I'm here today to recognize, drum roll, please. There's the real one. Aaron Holmes! Woohoo! Girl boss, exactly. How fun is that? So Aaron is our 2022 Schmidt Music High School Music Educator of the Year. It's pretty cool. So we're really proud of that. So Aaron launched her career back in 2000. In 2017, School Band and Orchestra Magazine named her one of the nation's 50 directors who make a difference. Her favorite phrase that all you probably know already, but I just learned this, every day is a good day to get better. Do your practicing, right? In 2018, she was appointed as the jazz chair for Minnesota Music Educators Association, where she is the first woman in the organization's history to be chosen for this position. Woo-hoo! Can you stand all this attention? She also plays alto sax in the Swing Sisterhood Big Band, which is an all-woman big band. She is also an active director of honor bands and a clinician for music festivals, an educator for music contests, and teaches master classes all around our region. So, Brad, I'm going to have you take a picture of Aaron and me. We've got some awards here, and we can show it all out. Hold that. that's, we have two awards, so she got one for home and one for here. Oh, you got the camera, good. Oh, thank you. Simple, and you got this. We got this fancy crystal looking one. Is this still on? Yep. All right, you can hold that one too. Am I good? All right.
Thank you. I just don't have words. It's senior night, and yeah, I got tissues.
That piece is called Joy, and it just makes me happy. It's written in a very Copland style. It's supposed to sound very American, with the open fourths and the open fifths, and the use of the xylophones, very, very bright colors and timbres. Really great piece. So from America to Argentina with El Choclo, which is just a lovely, fun tango. You're going to love this. So we're going to continue the joy theme. We have one more tune, and then we're going to switch to the wind ensemble. And during that switch, the screen is going to come down again, and we are going to watch the senior slideshow. This is like a highlight of the spring concert, and we're so excited. I also have to point out, the senior slideshow is completely done by students. None of us directors have anything to do with it. We say, hey, would you like to have a senior slideshow at the concert? And of course, they all say, yes. And we say, all right, you got it. In fact, I haven't even seen it yet. It was sent directly to Mr. Mathis today and is loaded up and ready to go. So we're going to finish with this powerful piece called Con, which depicts images of battle. It is named after Genghis Khan, the ruthless warlord. And I picked this piece many months ago, and then the war in Ukraine broke out, and I almost pulled it. I don't want anyone to think that this piece is celebrating or glorifying war or violence or warlords, but it did allow us to have a really great conversation. We had one day in class where we talked pretty deeply about this piece and what it represents and how music can represent both the best and worst of humanity. Every emotion and every great event in history is either celebrated or mourned through the creation and sharing of music. So this is Con.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much. What a wonderful night. Concert band, amazing. Symphonic band, amazing. My colleagues, amazing. It is so much fun to make music and to be here and celebrating these amazing kids that have made it through 8 years of band in this amazing program. I could not be more proud of the grit, the determination, the passion, all of it just wrapped into one. And I just want to make a note to everybody here how much I appreciate all of my colleagues and every single one of their elementary and middle school band directors are here tonight, even the ones that are retired, congratulations, but they are all here supporting these amazing kids, so thank you. Like Mariska said, we will be brief in our comments, but we do want to make sure that we're celebrating our students tonight, so we'll read off a few of these amazing accomplishments in between each of these pieces. And I'm going to start off with the All-Conference Awards and what they are. The South Suburban Conference All-Conference recognition is awarded to students. Oh, sorry. You should stand up when I call your name. Okay. Sorry. Okay. It's awarded to students in recognition of outstanding contribution to instrumental music and dedicated to their chosen instrument. This year, Farmington had 6 students selected for All-Conference Awards. Please stand or wave, percussionists, when we say your name. Ashlyn Cox. Sydney Elrod. Colin Locke. Serena Finney. Alex Treacle. And Owen Walter.
Next, we're going to recognize our All-State members. The Minnesota Music Educators Association All-State is considered one of the top programs of its kind across the nation. The All-State program supports secondary school music ensembles, MMEA members, and members' students. It is the highest honor a high school musician can receive, and this year, Farmington had 6 students who participated in this highly competitive audition process and were selected to play in the All-State bands. Please stand when I say your names. Ashlyn Cox. Mackenzie Frame. Serena Finney. Jace Prosser. Emily Sheldon. And Owen Walter. We are also excited to announce that 6 students were recently named to the All-State bands for the coming year. Returning for a second year are Emily Sheldon and Jace Prosser. Along with Abby Burrish. Ronan Groyle. And alternates Brianne DeWilde and Becca Woody. The Minnesota State High School League Academics, Arts, and Athletics Award, commonly known as the AAA Award, honors high school seniors throughout the state who excel in academics, athletics, and the fine arts. We are proud to recognize that both recipients of this award from Farmington High School this year are in the band, and they are Olivia Cole and Paul Radke.
All right, now the next award that I'm gonna present is the Louis Armstrong Award, but it's a jazz award, and it's great to do it at a jazz concert, but look at this audience, it's fantastic. So I cannot pass up this opportunity to talk about this award. The Louis Armstrong Jazz Award was inaugurated in 1974 in memory of the great jazz artist. It honors the most outstanding musical achievement to the jazz program at each high school throughout the country. This year, we are giving this award to a student who has dedicated himself to developing his skills on his instrument through private lessons, being involved in many curricular and extracurricular ensembles at FHS, earned an all-conference award in the South Suburban Conference, and received the state's highest honor of being selected to the All-State Jazz Band, not once, but twice. He demands the same amount of respect and dignity from those around him as he does for himself, and emulates our band department's philosophy, every day is a good day to get better. With his superlative attitude and in combination with magnificent musicianship, we take great pride in presenting the prestigious Louis Armstrong Award to Owen Walter.
The Instrumental Music Department Award goes to a student that best exemplifies the mission, character, and integrity of the FHS bands. Each recipient models this for their peers and interacts with school staff in a mature manner. The student that we have selected for this year has been involved in band for 4 years, having gone above and beyond, volunteering for any task, working diligently on his own musical skills, including learning a new instrument simply out of a desire to help the band. Most importantly, he has an overall care for the legacy that he leaves for the future of the program by always helping others and always asking, how can I help? This is a student who not only has earned our respect, but gives respect and dignity to all those around him. His attitude and work ethic is something that he should take great pride in as we present this distinguished award to Joey Melhorn.
This next piece is an amazing piece, and it was brought to us by the Band Family Library. We had a family that donated some money to this, and I love having conversations with students about music. Like, they come into my office all the time, like, did you listen to this? Have you heard this before? And we came together on this piece to order this beautiful piece of music that's going to feature so many of these very fine musicians. So I hope that you enjoy John Mackey's Aurora Awakes. okay, before the seniors do their senior thing, notice that all the seniors from the entire band program are up here, but I'm going to give out two more awards before I exit the stage and they do their thing. It's always a surprise. We never know what's happening. I'm going to do what I can to get through this, but it's going to take me a minute. So, this award is on behalf of the Dettinger family, and I'm honored to be able to present for the second time the Jacob Dettinger Legacy Award and Scholarship. JD was a 2016 graduate of this high school. He lived in this recital hall for the 4 years he was a student at FHS, enthusiastically participating as a percussionist in every aspect of the Farmington Music programs. During his sophomore year at the University of Wisconsin-Eau Claire, where he was majoring in instrumental music education, he was diagnosed with glioblastoma brain cancer. He fought for 30 months with courage and bravery, but passed away on October 12th, at the age of 22. During JD's illness, he and his family were embraced and supported by friends and family, the Farmington community, by this school district, and by people across the country they never even knew. Because of the generosity of all those people, they have been able to establish a scholarship presented tonight in JD's honor. JD loved life and he loved music. He was positive, dedicated, talented, enthusiastic, and fiercely determined. He was a natural leader, and he faced cancer and everything with courage and grit. His love of family, his sense of humor, his compassion, and his resolve sustained him throughout his illness and his life. Every one of these characteristics were a part of JD, are the qualities that we look to in choosing a recipient for this award. While so many students in the band program deserve this award, our recipient stands above the others. The student has worked hard in every ensemble he's ever been a part of, dedicating his time to jazz band each morning, the concert ensembles throughout the day, marching band, winter percussion, and pep band in the evenings. Everyone knows this young man for his sharp ear, his dedication to his instrument, and the FHS band program. It means a great deal that a person like JD would see this talent and excitement, work ethic, friendly disposition, and leadership. And we know he would be so proud that he is the one receiving this award. It is my great honor to present the Jacob Dettinger Legacy Award and Scholarship to Blake Williams. Did I do better than last year? Thank you. Okay. The final award that we will present tonight is the John Philip Sousa Award, and it is the pinnacle of achievement in a high school band. Introduced in 1955 to honor the top student, the John Philip Sousa Award recognizes superior musicianship, character, and integrity. Each recipient models this for their peers and interacts with staff in a mature and musical manner. The FHS band directors strive to instill these qualities in all of our students. The recipient of this award has proven the worth of this description since the day she walked into the FHS music suite when she was a freshman. No matter the task, the student has been the consummate professional as a member of her ensembles, been a leader to all students around her, and a model musician. We are so proud of the work she has done as the co-section leader in the marching band, leadership in the wind ensemble in Jazz One, with her unrivaled attitude towards making the program stronger, and in combination with her dedication to music, we take great pride in this future music educator and present the prestigious John Philip Sousa Award to senior Hannah Baum.
have all you guys come up here and stand in a line, please? Thank you. And Holmes and Veriska, could you join them? Yeah, that'd be awesome. While they get up there, I'll start my speech because I'm going to try to make it short because I know how long this concert goes. Yeah, that'd be awesome. You guys can, yeah. You might want to move down more. There's a lot of you guys. So my name is Mackenzie Frame. I play bass clarinet, and obviously I'm a senior. So I'm giving this speech on behalf of the whole senior class. This year we decided to do things a little differently, just like our high school experience has been. It's crazy to think that we are on to the next chapter, and whether that includes playing our instruments or not, it's really something to celebrate. Of course, there's some people I'd like to thank. So Ms. Christensen and Mr. Aselson, you have both been so patient in helping us choose our instruments and listening to our beautiful sounds. We thank you so much for helping us start this amazing musical journey. Ms. Miklich, Ms. Gordon Mercer, Mr. Lasko, Ms. Olson, Mr. Grothy, and Ms. Ellingson. You guys saw us truly find our path to music. Through all the hormones and middle school shenanigans, we thank you for bringing us together and giving us band. Dalma, Mr. Mariska, and Ms. Holmes, where do I even begin? Thank you for bringing us to this point, for challenging us as musicians and people. Thank you for teaching us to be ourselves and to leave our legacy. Thank you. We wanted to thank you all for giving us the gift of music, knowing that you have helped us leave our legacy, and well, your legacy will stay with us forever. I'm done torching you guys now, so you can take a seat if you'd like. Thank you. The seniors come together to give the high school band directors a gift. We felt it was important to thank all the directors and all the band directors here today because they're all part of our journey here. When all the seniors look back at the past 4 years, a few main things stick out. Holmes and Mariska say a lot of things, but three things truly are ingrained in our head as freshmen. Every day is a good day to get better, the band always wins, and to leave your legacy. We thought about how we could leave our legacy. Yes, obviously everyone will remember us because we're amazing, but how could we show how much this program truly means to us? Now this took a lot of different people to pull together, especially behind your guys' backs. So Ms. Miklich helped me create a Schoology page back in sophomore year, and along with Ms. GM, they helped us get all this organized and all these teachers here today. End of sophomore year, we got together and officially agreed to move on with this idea. Through junior year, we met via Zoom and continued to work on the gift. Once our gift was prepared, we all had to do was perfect it. We met in secret twice a week for multiple months, making sure everything was right and to truly show how much this program meant to us. Mr. Lasko was there for every meeting and helped us get this gift together. He gave us... He gave us the gift of his knowledge and selflessness, and we thank him for spending his evenings with a bunch of high school students. Some of those meetings, we got a lot more work done than others, but we were always laughing. During one especially fun meeting, I started writing down all the funny things Mr. Lasko would say, and the list got long really quick. Even though you said we didn't owe you anything, we felt we needed to give you something to say thank you and to show how many smiles you gave us, so we compiled a list of all the quotes together in a collage. We hope that whenever you read those, they make you laugh and remember all those meetings, because they were truly memorable. And that's not even all of them. Now that I'm done explaining the process, let's get to the gift. We wanted to give the directors something that embraced every aspect of this amazing band program and our journey. We came up with something that took everything from our love and dedication to band and our high school journey and put it together into something that showed how much music can make a difference and how important it is to education. It shows not just our journey through high school, but our journey through band, from starting out only as being able to play a few notes and basic rhythms to the developed musicians we have become today. It shows our ups and downs through our high school journey with the sudden end of COVID-19 in sophomore year. Everything we have encountered and endured, and finally, how this may be the end of our high school career, but there is so much more that we have to do. So, without further ado, I present Legacy by the Farmington High School Senior Class of 2022 and Shirley Meyer.
So 2 years ago, January 2020, I came down to rehearse a piece of mine, Maiden Voyage. They were rehearsing it, and after the rehearsal, Mackenzie Frame came up to me, and little did I know what was in store. Mackenzie, thank you so much for asking me to do this. It's been an honor and a privilege and a joy to work with you. Seniors, thank you for all your time, talent, over the past 2 years and over the past 2 months especially, and your ideas that went into the creation of this piece. Thank you, juniors, for playing with us tonight and for rehearsing with us too. We couldn't have done it without you. And Joe Lasco, thank you. Where did you go? Yeah, right. We couldn't have done it without you either. Thank you, parents, families, everyone here tonight, for coming out to support these young musicians, and everyone tuning in at home too. And lastly, Bradley, Aaron, Elliot, where'd you go? There you are. Lastly, thank you from the bottom of my heart for the incredible work that you do every day with these young musicians, for inspiring the kind of high level of musicianship and dedication that it takes to do something like this. Thank you. It's thanks to you that the band always wins.
Thank you. After keeping this gift a secret for 3 years, it was kind of hard for me to just like kind of blurt out and say before we showed, but if you couldn't guess on, all of us together got a piece commissioned for the band directors in honor of them. So we have a picture of the front score for you, each of you, for your offices that we all signed. So the piece is called Legacy because they always tell us to leave our legacy. So we wanted to make sure we left our legacy. And you can see we went through the whole process with Shirley. We picked out what we wanted, we told her what we wanted in the piece, and we really wanted it to be our journey through high school, show how much we can grow, but also how this is not the end. And the front of it's even special, it has a music score, and all of our signatures are in the score, in the music note. So you all remember us.
They weren't kidding when they said I'd need tissues. And I obviously normally do saying goodbye to these kids and having such an amazing night, but wow, like, I can't. It literally says the band always wins on it. I don't know what to say right now. Like, I usually have words, and I just don't. I'm so proud of everybody in this room and what you've accomplished tonight and what you're going to accomplish in the future, whether it's outside of these walls, out into the world. Parents, you guys have done an amazing job setting them up for success. And we are just the lucky ones that get to work with them every single day and push them and challenge them and encourage them and love them, no matter if they're chewing gum on the day of a concert or not. I kid because I love, but no, honestly, like, I was going up to sit down, and I saw Shirley Meyer, and I'm like, what? And this blows me out of the water. Like, this is just, what a gift of music, and to continue, like, really, truly living the legacy that we talk about all the time. It really matters. So thank you so much for everything all the parents did, all the music educators have done, the administration, my colleagues here every single day, our choral colleagues. This is just beyond gratitude. I don't know what else to say. So thank you so much. I love Farmington. I'm so glad. I'm so glad to be raising my kids in this community, in this environment, and the support that everybody has. I want to tell you a little secret. I didn't have time to shop. A former band parent bought this dress for me. God bless you, Sue Dettinger. Okay. I had to. One time, Sue. One time. Everybody takes care of me and takes care of my kids, and I'm just so grateful. All of you. Thank you so much, all of you out here. Everything that you do every single day, it really, truly matters how you treat people. Stay playing music. Do the music. It's so valuable. We're so grateful for all of you. Thank you so much. We're not done. We still have one more piece, so we'll switch it up. So thank you so much, seniors. This is tremendous.
Thank you. So great.
Yes, of course. Thank you. Let's put that in the, this is just tremendous. That was, guys, all good. Okay, so we are going to close with this amazing, it's such a fun piece by Michael Markowski. It's called Femitius Fantasticus. And I do want to warn the audience, some of the what's happening might get a little bit close to you, but I'm not going to tell you anything because it's really, really fun. But please enjoy this piece. I have so enjoyed teaching it. This whole night has humbled and honored. I'm just so honored by all of this and all of you. Thank you so much. Thank you for being here. Thank you to our students in the booth for all the running of everything tonight. We really appreciate you. Yes. I'm sure there's things I'm forgetting, and I'm so sorry. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Check, check. Hey, seniors, I need everybody, all the seniors on stage, all the seniors and the band directors on stage, please. Check, check. Is Cindy Krueger still here? Is Cindy Krueger still here? Can you take a photo of the seniors and the band directors?